Hi, today we'd like to look at component builders options, or what we would call global settings. Now I possibly through the tutorials have from time to time touched on certain areas, but now we would like to give a more precise look at the options area of component builder. It's accessible through the options button, and if you have the permissions you will see this button and can open it. The permissions, by that I mean certain users may not see this button if they are in a different group than the global administrator, and you can change those permissional structures as needed. So you click on options and this will open the component builder configurations or global settings, as it's often referred to, or options or settings. And there are a number of switches here that is worth knowing about. These areas here, you can add your own details if you would like to have it displayed in the component's front end. Then there is a switch here, a check-in timer. We build into Component Builder the option to check in the items every so often. And here you can check if an item has been locked out for 5 hours, it brings it back in, 12 hours, 24 hours, every second day, once a week, or never. So the check-in timer is set here, and you can change it to whatever is best suited to your system. Then enabling version control is what this area is all about. You can disable it by simply saying no, or enable it by yes, and then you can say how many versions should be kept of the item. If zero, all old versions will be saved. So zero means everything, and so you can limit it to sort of prevent your system from being overloaded with data in the database. Then you have minify JS feature. Basically, all the JS that is being built in a component builder can be changed to be minified. So while you're in production, you can export your components without minifying the JS in the files and in the footers of the documents. But the moment you feel that you've reached the place where minification is necessary and you want to use it, then you'd simply trip the switch here, and that would minify the JS, which is your JavaScript in the component while it's being compiled. Okay, and then just some details. My wife being very involved in discussing, she's a Java developer, and helping me look at some of the implementations, as well as my own details. And like I said, you can add more contributors here, and they will show up in the dashboard underneath contributors. Then the UIKit settings. This is primarily for the backend at the moment being implemented in certain areas, but this is only really needed most of the time in the front-end framework of your component. So I've added it to Component Builder simply so that it's there if I at some point decide to start adding a front-end shop for the components that's being developed. That's part of what we possibly would design eventually, is a front-end distributing software that was built by Component Builder, so you could install this and then run it from your, it's like a factory with a front end basically. And that is still in planning. We're still looking at some of the security risks, since so far we've been encouraging people to use the component builder offline and not online. So we're not even sure how this will work. Possibly we might end up with two components. Okay, then the encryption settings. Component Builder has a few places where it encrypts some of the data in the database. And we are using a basic encryption, which means we are using this key that you enter here. Once you've entered this key, I think because it ships without a key in it, so it'll look like that. So once you've entered a key, please ensure that you don't change it, because this key is what locks the data and it's the only key that can unlock it. So if you remove this key, you cannot unlock it. So you could remove it if you wanted to prevent people from knowing the data in those fields, but then you need to save it somewhere else, because if you don't have it, and you know, then you can't retrieve the data and decrypt it. Okay, then next up is folder paths. The folder paths, there are two folder paths that you already can make use of, the backup folder and the Git folder path. Please read related notation here. Whereas the custom folder path and the compiler folder path, I would suggest at this stage that you don't make any changes to them. I added these fields because I envisioned the possibility that we want to move these folders out of our web area of developing, since these are part of the security concerns we have, that these files and these folders might be targeted. But I haven't fully implemented this all across the compiler infrastructure. So currently it's best to leave that that folders the way they are by not adding any data in here. Oh, sorry, I clicked on the back button there. Anyway, so by just leaving these fields blank, we ensure that the... Next up, we can look at permissions. Now, the permissional structure in Component Builder is not that intense, but as you can see, there are a lot of permission switches. With the latest Joomla release of Joomla 3.5, this permissional structure updating construct is made much easier. In the past, we had a problem where the data set of your permissions is so big that when you save it, it just freezes up your browser, and even the server doesn't want to receive the data set, it's too big. Now they've added AJAX per field, which makes this so much easier. That means that currently, without clicking save and close, you can make changes to the permissional structure, and that immediately will be stored to the database. That's from version 3.5 of Joomla. Now, how would that be? You see, we still have these areas that we also want to store. So what I have thought might work, now possibly my implementation isn't that accurate, but you have here configurations only as a permission. So I would say take a certain group, give them that configuration only access, and then log out of this user, log into a user that is in that group, then this permissional tab won't show. They will only see these settings, and which are in these tabs, right? And so they can make changes to these and save them without any browser latency or overload. Whereas you can come in and you can just tweak the permissions when you are in the global or super administrator role. So you can come in here and you can tweak the permissions accordingly. So as you saw previously, when I was here in the manager area, I could just change this, and it does an AJAX storing of the value in the database, which is really smart. I'm very grateful that they've done that. So for the main reason that this set of permissions became so huge that I in some places had to do server adjustments on some of my components to ensure that the user could still save and change the permissions. Now, so you have your global create, delete, edit, edit state, edit own, edit created by, and edit created date, and then you get the per view permission structure. So here is the admin view, then the custom admin view, the dynamic get, and they all have their own different areas that you can change permissions for groups to be able to do this or that. this same permission implementation options and structures are available to all components built by Component Builder as you trip the switches for the fields as well as for your certain views. Let me just go out of this to show you. Go components, then first we look at the components, summon distributor. Here in the admin views you have here, and let's just close this. This access control, but this is not the only place of implementation. Let's just update that. Save and close. If you go to the admin views, and let's say we open Preacher, you have the permissional structure here for edit. Now if you select view, it's going to use the view name. If you select core, it'll fall back on the core edit and delete features corresponding. So if you use the word view, view.edit, you'd see in the permissional structure an edit switch with this view's name, preacher.edit. Whereas you use the word core.edit, you would only see edit or delete or create, whatever one of these you'd select. And this in relation to each record means that it will be added to the record itself. You can tweak the edit structure. This is only global setting, or this is for both. And so that is partly how you control some of those permissional switches we just looked at. The other area is in fields itself. You have here a permissional structure where you can say, okay, this specific field, let's say the preacher name, I want to control that permission. Who can edit it? Is what you would add a who edit button. Currently, we are not yet implementing who can view, since we were having problems with the tremendous overload of switches being added to the permissional structure. But since Joomla has now made this change, we might possibly add that in. Then you can even have a view, who can view that that field. Whereas this is currently just who can edit it. Okay, so this is the how you get a fields permissional switch. Now, let me give you this as an example. Let's make that one for now. Name. Say that it must be a permission. Save and close. Save and close. Here I have Sermon Distributor open, so I'll open its options. Go to its permissional tab, then scroll down, and I see first here is the help documents, and then here is Preacher. And Preacher has site access, and then access to Preacher itself, and batch, create, dashboard add, dashboard list, delete, edit. Edit created by, edit created date, edit own, edit state, edit version, export, import, submenu, and then it starts with series. So as you can see, it doesn't show name here yet. So what we'll do is now we'll go back to Component Builder, go to Compiler, and we will select Sermon Distributor and compile it. Once it's completed, I'll just click on this install button here to do a quick install. Now that that's completed, let's go back to the configuration and just refresh the page. I'll just click on the refresh here at the top. Now if we scroll down again, we'll get here, we see it got a new field here called Preacher Edit Name. And now I can decide, can this group edit that name, or is it denied, or should it be inherited? So the permissional structure per field can be added in this way. I'm going to go back and revert that because I actually don't want I don't want that area to be monitored. So go back, open Preacher, go back to the fields, say no, save and close, compiler, select sermon distributor, compiling it, then installing it, going back, refresh, and we see that the field is gone. So it's no longer being controlled by this permissional infrastructure. And so that is how you can tell which group is able to access which fields, and even which views are accessible through the permissional structures. This is an amazing advantage of Component Builder in its ability to integrate permissions not only per view, but also per field in a view, and your normal control also related to a specific view. And not only that, it also adds these permissions to every item. So you could override an item and say, okay, this item, I don't want that group to actually access this field. And this is one of the advantages that Component Builder has above other similar applications out there. It's its ability to implement some of the most advanced concepts that are currently accessed or available in Joomla. Okay, so that's a quick look at the global configuration options for Component Builder. Thank you for watching.